Hi, I'm Alex Tsyplikhin. I'm a senior AI engineer at Graphcore. In this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to switch from GPU to Graphcore's IPU when you're using TensorFlow. Today, I'll be demoing this for a probabilistic method called Markov Chain Monte Carlo, or MCMC, using TensorFlow probability. MCMC is well suited to noisy data with nonlinear predictions. It has a lot of different industry use cases, particularly in finance, where it can be used for alpha estimation, risk estimation, and option pricing. For MCMC in TensorFlow probability, there are some very interesting performance gains too, which I'll discuss later on in this demo. Let us quickly walk through the original GPU code to see what's happening here. So first, we initialize model parameters and dataset parameters. In this case, we want to do 100 of burn-in steps, and we want to produce 800 samples from the posterior of the model parameters. Also doing 1,000 of leapfrog steps. Then we print out a nice welcome message. We load the dataset here, print out the dataset features, parameters, how many samples here. We initialize TensorFlow, including the session. We build the model we want to run here, and it's a simple neural network with a few layers. Then in this function, we initialize the prior distributions over model parameters, and we connect model predictions with ground truth using this student distribution, and we output the log probability of the resulting two variables. After that, we build the data set in the form of static tensors in this case. We initialize the chain state with zeros. We create a variable for step size. And finally, we create a kernel for HMC, Hamiltonian Monte Carlo, and an op to sample from the chain. And after that, we do a warm-up run, and we time our session.run in these lines. And finally, we write the produced samples to a file and print the runtime. Now, when we go on and start changing this program to run on IPU, the following things would happen. We will want to include a couple of specific modules for the IPU. Then most of the code is, of course, unchanged. We want to remove this GPU specific option. And in this line, we tell TensorFlow to put the computational graph on our device, IPU0. After that, we encapsulate our MCMC ops in this Python function, and we use IPU compiler to compile the TensorFlow graph. Finally, we configure the IPU system, allocating one IPU as one TensorFlow device. And the rest of the code is unchanged. So in this case, our MCMC chain, one chain, will run on one IPU. And we know that we have two IPUs per accelerator card. So we want to potentially leverage those both IPUs. It will be the same power budget as the GPU, 300 watts in both cases. So we can now change our IPU code slightly to leverage the two IPUs and compare the performance better. Now, what would change if we want to run not across one IPU, but across two IPUs for MCMC? So we want to introduce this new model parameter, number of IPUs. Each of the IPUs would produce 400 results, so that combined number of results would be 800. Then again, most of the code is unchanged. and we are adding this convenience function build graph that simply adds variable scope to put all the graph inside that variable scope. And then we will want to run a few separate ops. Each op would mean running one TensorFlow graph on a separate IPU. So we produce a list of ops that serves as input to our session.run. And when allocating IPU devices, we will create several TensorFlow devices, each with one IPU. So one IPU per TensorFlow device, which is specified here. And finally, we run our ops, we time the execution, we then concatenate the results from these two separate MCMC chains, and we do the same. We write the results to the file and we output the runtime. Some researchers have seen that having many MCMC chains produce the results for us, results in some kind of better generalization for the model. And this is because probably these chains end up searching different areas in the space of model parameters. Now, I have tried running the GPU code and the IPU code that we have just seen on the actual devices. So on a P3 instance in AWS EC2, the runtime for 800 samples was about 729 seconds, while when we are running on two IPUs to produce the same number of samples, the runtime is 48 seconds. So the total speed up in this case is over 15 times. I also want to mention that the IPU code to run across two IPUs is available in our public GitHub repository, so GitHub Graphcore examples, and you are very welcome to explore this code on your own. So let's run through a few of the main takeaways from this demo. Number one, it's easy to program an IPU and easy to switch from GPU to IPU with just a few small changes to the code in TensorFlow. Number two, the IPU processor delivers a huge performance advantage for MCMC using TensorFlow probability. While consuming the same power as GPU, our accelerator card with two IPUs runs MCMC over 15 times faster. In some real-world scenarios, this results in 3 hours time to train on IPU versus 45 hours on GPU. Number three, it's worth exploring emerging AI models. New performance advantages are opening up opportunities to work with methods such as MCMC that have not been as widely exploited because they don't work so well with legacy hardware. Thanks for watching. We'll be happy to answer any questions you have. So get in touch via our website, graphcore.ai. And you can check out more of our Poplar software documentation and benchmarks there.